Hi, this is Simon from Hand Circus. Me and Shane are going to give you a tour of OKABU, some of the features you can come to expect when it's released next week. We're going to dive into one of the levels from the end of World 1, Dozer Destruction, and show you what Monkfish and Piccolo gave block. First of all, we need to get rid of these dozer bots, and get rid of the pollution that litters this area. So you can see we're using water to spray these plants, raining the plants to push back the pollution boundary. We're also using them to take out the little dozer bots. To get through the next section though, we're going to need something a bit more explosive. So we're going to go and get Piccolo and Monkfish. There's a switch over here that Monkfish can operate. Pulling the switch produces one of these exploding blocks. Next, to get it down, we're going to need to get a ball down from this cage. Aha! Next, Piccolo can charm the ball, making it run on this pad. The pad powers the conveyor, and voila, we've got an exploding block. We drag that over to the wall, we set it alight, we can blast our way through. Next thing we need is a bit of oil, so accumulo a nimby, suck up some oil. We can use the oil to paint the path and the fire over to the block. You can see it's pretty fast, so we're going to need both of us working together. So this level is part of the second world, Caribou Valley. Monkfish and Piccolo have arrived at a temple that's been discovered underneath the sands, and they need to find a way in. The door to the temple is controlled by a big ruby that sits above the gate, so we've got to try and find a way to light up that ruby. Fortunately, you can see over to the left, there's a big magnifying glass. You can see the magnifying glass isn't pointing in the right direction at the moment, so we need to get this little guy using Piccolo, lure him across and get him to operate this switch. And this switch will make the mirror rotate so we can guide the light, starting to guide it in the right direction. Obviously, as well as the Yorubu, there's various other creatures dotted around the environment that Piccolo can control. In this case, we're just luring these chicklets across. Now, chicklets, the best thing they can do is eat through these big green bushes. And the goat's free. You can use the goat to smash through the wooden barrier just below. In this section, we're going to take a look at the final world, the Dozer Fortress. As well as being useful for smashing through fences, balls are awesome for combat. Let's see what happens when a charging ball meets a dozer. If you ever see something you like the look of hanging from a tree, you just get Monkfish to give it a shake. These explosive nuts are perfect for blasting through rock. So you can see we found a big switch hidden behind those blocks. We go back and grab Monkfish, we can pull that switch, which will open the gates, getting us through the next section.